Hey, how are we doing tonight? We are live playing a game that is so unbelievably terrible. I honestly say this is worse than the Kiss Psycho Circus game. This is awful. This is special. This is Daikatana level special.
It's not too bad, even as a prototype. The force of Sadako
The force of Sadako Yamamura?
Well, it's unlikely to be a homicide case. We'll get to the bottom of this.
Virus, what? What are you talking about, Chief?
Yeah, and I think we're just gonna have to do it that way.
Virus, what? What are you talking about, Chief?
Yeah, and I think we're just gonna have to do it that way.
That's right.
Please, you have to help me.
We're playing The Ring Terror's Realm for the Dreamcast. This is a terrible game. I got maybe 20 minutes into it before I couldn't anymore. It starts out hilarious and then it's kind of sloggy. But I'm thinking it's going to be, like, pockmarked with, you know, hilarious moments and just really shitty, boring moments. So we're gonna suffer this together. And we're going to be throwing this back up onto the YouTube channel once we really get some steam going. Got to adjust the mic a bit. So I'm going to actually let you guys enjoy this opening sequence. I'm not saying a goddamn word. In fact, I'm going to be muting my mic because this intro sequence, which is long and boring, is one of the funniest fucking things I have ever seen. Ever. And I would never deprive you of enjoying this shit. So, I want to actually see if it actually saves. Or maybe I never... I don't think I ever got to save... These sound effects are fucking beautiful. Okay, so I never got a chance to save the game I was playing before. So we are going to start from the beginning, regardless. I never found a save point in all the time I was playing. So, here we are. This is The Ring Terror's Realm for the Dreamcast.
Hello?
Meg?
Robert, get the job?
Yeah, I'll be working with you starting tomorrow, so I guess I'll be seeing you soon.
Really? That's great. So why don't we go out for a celebratory drink?
Okay. I'll get ready.
Promise?
Promise. Bye for now. Well, who the hell does she think she is? She hasn't any idea of how important this project is. But Sadako...
Robert, he didn't sound so pleased, even though it's been quite a while since we spoke. He's absolutely Mr. Thickhead, even on my last birthday. Well, today's the day. He has to make up for it. Robert?
Yeah, and I think we're just gonna have to do it that way. And that's just a... Hey! Hey, miss. No, I'm sorry, you can't come in here. You're gonna have to get out of here. Or do you live here?
What's happened, officer?
What's happened, officer? No, I'm asking
Watch
you a question. Do you live here? Hello? Miss?
Watch out!
Robert?
Hello? Hey. Hey, stop, lady.
It's Robert! No!
You okay, lady?
Meg! Meg! What's going on over there? Like, hey, ma'am, what's happening here?
Hold on a moment, sir.
I know the two of them. They're friends. What happened? I don't believe this.
I see.
Oh, Meg!
Could you explain your relationship to either her or the victim?
Yeah, I know the two of them. They're both my friends. I'm Jack, and this is Robert's girlfriend, Meg.
Oh, I see. Well, I'm
sorry. What happened to Robert?
Actually, we don't yet exactly know what happened to him this evening.
You don't know? Isn't this a murder?
Okay.
It's unlikely to be a homicide case.
Not a murder? Then what's that? Did you see his face? What's happened? Oh my God!
Well, we'll get to the bottom of this.
I'm still alive. I'll work for this company without you, Robert. I shouldn't mourn your death forever. Right.
Oh my God, this is fucking terrible. Alright, so that was the intro movie, and now we are technically playing the game. And I mean, you can tell it's a horror game because I mean, just listen to that terrifying music, right, Alessa? So now we're working in Robert's lab, because that's how jobs work. Like, we didn't have any clue what her job was prior to this, but the second her boyfriend dies, she immediately takes over his job, because, sure, no good comes from me moping around all the time. He died yesterday. What the fuck is wrong with this game? Okay, so controls in this game are your standard tank controls. And X actually spins us faster. That beautifully rendered jacket is empty. And this is Robert's computer, obviously. So a couple of things to note is that running in this game is a pain in the ass, only because it's got this like half second delay. Ninth Gate, Iron Rhino, thank you for joining. I appreciate you stopping by. You're gonna enjoy the fuck out of this. Okay, so like I said, there's kind of a delay when you're running full step. Alright, so yeah. And then my favorite part of this entire game is the backward motion when you're running. Normal going back? Running going back! Fucking rabbit style. This game's beautiful. So let's try to leave. Also, another thing this game does for some reason is sometimes text will automatically leave the screen. So like you see the little arrow, I can sit here and wait for the game, you know, forever. And then it only goes when I press the A button, and sometimes it'll just scroll on its own. It makes no sense. See? What the fuck is she talking about? Who the fuck is Jack? What is his problem that's so much more important than your boyfriend dying? Right, Alessa? Right? Thank you. I heard a slightly strange story. Not quite strange, just a tad bit. Oh yeah, we're at the Center for Disease Control. Two other people died at the same time and same way Robert did. Oh yeah, you're gonna see that a lot, by the way. That happens a lot. So this is our introduction to what is essentially the game's main conceit. So this is going to be fun. So there's a game on their computers called Ring. It wouldn't boot! This game is literally a creepypasta turned into a video game. Died thanks to a computer program. I died thanks to a guy stabbing me in the face. Thanks, guy. That is such a dumb fucking way to word it. I died thanks to somebody killing me. And number two. Again, that's not how jobs work. I'm sure Robert's happy, but he's dead! He hasn't a feeling in the world. He is dead. Rhino posits, if it killed you for playing it, what do you think happened to the program? Alright, so we're gonna take a look at Robert's laptop. Come on. There we go. Ring, a killer computer program. How does it make you wonder? That is so outside the realm of logic. Apparently, it's an auto-booting program that's the only program on the computer. And this music makes me want to punch myself in the dick repeatedly. So, strap in, and hopefully you enjoy that music, because you're going to hear that a lot. So this is the second part of the game. This is less Clock Towery and more Resident Evil, but think shittier. Like, way shittier. Somehow she already has an in-game avatar that looks exactly like her. I boot up a program called Ring on the computer. I should investigate. Okay. Oh, nope, we don't get to control yet. What I'm doing, booting up this computer. No, you already did that. We're well past that stage. The computer's booted, you're in the video game. What are you saying? She's saying she booted up a computer. Well, in the situation we're in, I can understand you getting confused. She said she booted up a computer. Nobody's confused except you. Making me wear this and all. This is awful. This is our battlefield against them. them. What are you saying? Jesus fucking Christ! All she said was them. He's like, what the fuck? What crazy alien language are you using? All I hear are bleeps and bloops. The writing in this game is so fucking bad. Anyway, we have no time for this. One of them is snuck in here. Check the first floor. We'll go to the second. Check the second. Why is that a question? She's dumb as shit, too. What the fuck is a second floor? And what do you mean by check it? Enough of this already. Speaking for everyone. Is that gun you're holding a fake? Quit yakking and go kill them off. If you're too slow, they'll get us. You've got a gun too, my friend. Kill them, but you're the one that made me hold this gun. No, he's not! You just woke up with it! There's no way I can use it without learning how. A valid point. I'm appalled that someone would stand here without knowing how to use a gun. That fucking, like, just fish-faced look he's got going on there.
You can't believe you don't know how to use a gun.
Informatics department? That's not even an actual department. It's not even close to a word. Alright, so we're going to go through a quick tutorial on how to play the game. Flashlight. Flashlight has batteries for some goddamn reason in this game. So you can use a gun. The gun automatically targets within 45 degrees in front of you. So that's not a very large range. It only targets where the flashlight shines. So, if you don't want enemies to see you, you have to have the flashlight off. But if you want to kill them, you gotta turn it on. The gun shoots, push A. Yeah, I know how to do that. Boom. Good job, team. Gun has a laser sight. Fucking obvious. Some weapons don't have sights. Woo. We can equip weapons. We can reload. This basically does something that a number of games kind of did, but never really told you about. I think Resident Evil was one of them, where the faster way of reloading your weapon was to go into the menu and then manually reload it in the menu. And then that way you're not open to getting attacked by enemies. So, this game actually does this well, where it kind of gives you that, hey, you know, you can do this, so you're not getting shit-canned all the time. So, credit where due. Check health on status screen. Green is good, red is bad. And check yourself before you wreck yourself. Alright, so, pretty standard screen. Regular items are here. And then these are your key items, so, like, keys, or anything that's not a standard item type, like healing, will be on this screen. We've got a map, which is actually not too bad. I noticed that it does give information, like, extra information that a lot of other games don't. So, again, fair dues on this game for that. But, so that's pretty much the quick rundown of that. Let's get out of here. Okie dokie. So now it's time for us to go to the second floor. Woo. It's just quickly loading up the next section. And by quickly, I mean going slow as shit. Changing viewpoints. Push Y. It will shift to first person. You have to hold it down, and then you use the analog stick to look around. I don't know why, but whatever. So, woo, like that.
Rang! You gotta use Y to change your point of view.
Alright, so that's the basics. No, we do not. We are not going to link this. Alright, so we need healing items. Healing jelly. Hopefully I'll have some whatchamacallit, the joke died in my brain. Gonna make a joke about peanut butter. But I forgot the word for whatever you take to heal poison. Damn it. That would have been a good joke, too. I'm sad. Anti-venom. Is it anti-venom? Antidote. Antidote peanut butter and health jelly. There we go. Yay, I did the joke. Isn't as good as it would have been, but fuck you. I did it. So there's no real quick turn in this game. It's just if you hold down the run button, you'll turn faster. What is this? This is stupid. Pretty much the tagline for this game. And here are the enemies. He's reckless. I have to do... fuck it. I don't know what it is. It could probably be okay, but I'm gonna kill it because I was told to. And yes, that is an ape monster. I don't know what it has to do with the ring. Give me the... Oh my god, these sound effects are so bad. I just want the handgun bullets. Thank you. Just generic sound effects. I deserve that. Oh no. Where is he coming from? Is he coming from that way? Is he stuck? I think it's stuck. Nope, there he is. Beautiful. Look at that. Now, I took 2 hits, and I'm still in the green. Amazing, isn't it? Isn't this just like the best game you've ever seen? I don't know what monkey creatures have to do with the ring, but... There you fucking go! I think this would be the greatest thing I've ever LP'd. I defeated the upstairs enemy, but now... How do I... What? My body... I feel ill. Hey, what's wrong? She just fucking said she feels ill! Why is everybody dumb? Why? Why are you all dumb? And how does that even fucking work? How did we get an avatar that looked exactly like us? Like, there's no logic behind it. And not even in a way where we could suspend our disbelief for just a brief moment and accept it as is. There's literally no way in any universe that you could connect these two segments together. It makes no sense. I'm gonna yell at him for making me play this game. And I'm gonna yell at myself for playing this game. Woo, spooky! Okay, so that's all we can do here. nothing else to do in here, so we are gonna... Oh, wait, actually, I never checked the sink in my place. There are sinks in every lab. So now we're gonna lose control again for a little bit. Because the game's gotta do some, plot dumping. So this is Chris that we're meeting. Meg Rainman, no affiliation. So we're going to the chief's office, alright. That's not how anybody in places like this ever act. Ever. We're like dipshits, Realm. Okay, so we walk forward just a little bit and cutscene. Except now we're all the way the fuck back at the door. Hopefully you can't hear the TV. If so, I've turned it down just enough so I can still hear it. We were serviced by Robert. Jeez. What kind of fucking company is this at the CDC? Holy crap. Robert was our special masseuse. That guy could work a keyboard. Yes, I think you need to work hard too. So we're going back over the same bullshit that we learned, what was it, 10 minutes ago? Three people died at the exact same time in the exact same way. We got it! Thank you! So, they think it's a virus. This is the best facility against virus for the public. Know the world! We are the greatest! They want to make an explanation ASAP. And also they're quarantining everybody for some reason. They think it's a virus, but like, it, I don't know, just everything that about this makes no sense. I guess the quarantine does make sense, yeah, but let's just like, no virus does this. You could say we've been quarantined. Yeah, you've been quarantined. You could say that. No, it is. It's not unusual for this facility. Dude, if you're getting quarantined on a regular basis where you're used to it, you're doing your job wrong. The point is to prevent and control diseases, not have them wreaking havoc all the fucking time. Okay, so they're gonna be quarantined for 2 to 3 days. You're free to roam in the facility. Have a look around. Right now we're checking for virus leakage from the basement. So you can only see the second floor. So then you're not free to go anywhere in the facility, jackass! What you should be seeing is, right now you can only go to the second floor. That's where you're allowed to look. That's it. It's not free to go wherever you want. Rainbuster! Hey, how you doing? Thanks for stopping by the stream. Hope you're having a great day. Hope all of you are having a great day. Appreciate y'all being here and watching this nonsense. So now we have an ID card. Go look around the facility, but only the second floor. Alright, so, our next order of business... Well, thanks for stopping in, Brainbusta. I appreciate it. Have yourself a good one. Enjoy your 3-day weekend and working from home. So now we gotta talk to this guy. This is Timothy. Yes, that's what I said. All right, so we gained a lot of insight from that conversation. Now, I think the next part I gotta do is just kind of wander until the next flag gets triggered. So we're gonna head out this way. And I don't think I actually have to go into any of the other rooms. I just gotta run to the end of the hallway. I'm gonna test that theory. And then through here. Their card really can't open a whole lot of areas. So that's our room. Brainbuster says this is like a really bland clock tower too. Yep. Okay, so that didn't exactly work. So I guess I gotta check all the rooms. Maybe I gotta just check in here? Like, it really, it gets super boring once you, oh. This is the men's locker room. Whoa, my good lord! Close your eyes, dude! Holy shit! Holy crap, that's just like a 1,000-yard stare piercing into my soul. Are you sure you're not the ring monster creature thing? Holy shit. I beg you. Who the talks? What kind of security guard talks like that?
I beg you, can you get out now?
Amazing. Yep, that's the security guard. Kind of looks like Xerxes from 300. Piercings all over. I beg you! And here's the ladies' locker room. Burger Gamer says he sees all! I don't know if I'm supposed to do... What, I don't really know how to actually trigger this event. There's an event that you get... that furthers this along. So we're gonna head back out here. We're gonna check some of the other rooms. So this is... Oops. So stairs. Ladies' room. Go in the fucking door. So this has some of the same painful trappings that games like Clock Tower had, where just these arbitrary flags you had to activate in order to further the story. She just shotgunned it right out. open that one, but can't do anything with it. There's no brooms, so... Rhino says, sorry I was gone for a bit. Was messing a bit with my Hot Wheels collection. Yep. Okay, let's see if we can go into the men's room. And there he is again. What? No, 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 no. You guys saw that shit too, right? Mean. M-E-E-N. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. Fucking wow. I didn't see that one my first time in. Holy shit. And this guy somehow teleported into here. Why is he in the bathroom? What is he guarding? I don't... Again, with the begging! My god! I did miss quite a lot in my original playthrough. Shit! Typos, bad characters. Oh, it's beautiful. So this is control room. And... Pretty much said, he's guarding the men's bathroom from women! He's just doing his job, man! Come on, lady, get out. Why are you in here? That's nothing. Let's check the sink. Nothing. No flavor text for the sink. What a dumb room. I'm upset by that. Okay, so, with those rooms covered, I should be able to move on now. Oh, I think I gotta go into my, my own room. Not 100% sure. I forgot how I did this. It's nice to have nobody around. So there's an item box that works kind of like the Resident Evil item boxes. Nope. Okay. So I gotta go into the other rooms and see that nobody's in. No use turning off the light switch. Oh. Okay. There we go. Awesome. Who the fuck is Jack? Again, virus outbreaks being uncommon at the CDC is not a thing. And it shouldn't be a thing if they're good at their jobs. Now we're recapping shit that we've just been through because this game hates us. There is a weird word on the screen. Weird word? It said Deb. How bizarre! The We're dead. It's so fucking weird. Alright, so this is new. So apparently Robert has been handed over to the CDC. Nah, they just wanted some snacks. The plot is surging along at this point. Jack says, don't go overboard. All I could think of was Titanic. This crap will go on and on. Literally, this entire section is just running back and forth from person to person. We just established that! We literally established that not even a minute ago, that that's what we were gonna do. Why does this game treat us like we're stupid? Aggravating! Legitimately, this game treats you like you're stupid throughout the whole game. It's amazing. So it's a bit of a long, long run back to the chief's room. And if I remember, as far as I got correctly, we run to the chief, then we run back to the doctor to our right, now to our left, and then we gotta find a key card. Rhino says, I hate this music now. Get used to it, my friend. Because we're going to be hearing it a lot. Shut up, Meg. Time to find out what they're doing with Robert's body. Dreambuster says, I haven't been here near that long, and I hate it too. Robert's body has been handed over to the lab. His body? What do you mean? You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of the dialogue. It reminds me of Metal Gear Solid, where every time somebody says something, Snake has got to respond with the last thing they said as a question. Metal Gear. Weapons. Sokolov. Can you spare us? Spare you what? This is no playground. You have her boyfriend's corpse. You're not responsible for it. What the fuck are you talking about? He's so hostile, too. Jesus shitting Christ. All she did was ask to see his body. And then she's hysterical about it. I regret that he died. And that I had no part in the death whatsoever. And that's a fair point. I mean, you know, she just wants to know what the fuck happened. It's not that bad, big of a deal. Now we're telling him about the ring game. That animation has no correlation to a bunch of ellipses. That's kind of like a... That's the opposite of that. I am busy! See, that's where you use that animation. A ring? A computer program? What the fuck is a computer program? I have no idea what you're talking about. Somebody tell me what a computer program is. I only work at the CD fucking C. Oh,
get out of here and cool off your hothead in your lab. He's flipping the fuck out and screaming at her and telling her to cool down. I can see clearly that you're not sane. Really? Because she mentioned a game? Really?
You brought up a computer application. You're fucking crazy!
This is amazing. She didn't mouth off. Everything was fine. She politely asked to see her dead boyfriend. He flipped the fuck out. Oh my god.
Shut up, Meg. Get out of this room.
Go cool off your head for a while. He's so fun. Oh my god, okay. Not gonna belabor it. Jesus. Holy shit. This game is amazing. Rhino shouting cool off. But I'm just
cool off already!
Okay. Oh, man. Please don't yell at me too, sir! Oh my god. Alright, so now they're trying to figure out the cause. There's a blah, until they find a virus, blah blah blah. He's hard to please, let me tell you. That's why I hunch over all the time. And then he puts it back on her! Holy shit, this is like one of the most sexist games I've played in a long time. God damn.
Woman, did you speak out of turn? Perhaps showing a bit too much leg?
Exactly!
When I asked about a program called Ring, he suddenly blew up at me.
I guess he must. That's not an excuse! I'm tired all the time, and I don't flip out on everybody in person. Just on the internet.
And now we're connecting some dots. Robert was talking about the ring, too.
And suddenly he doesn't remember, so now we know. He's hiding something. Robert didn't want to talk about it either. Yeah, I'm sure he did. He often talked about the reference room. So that's where our next location is, the reference room.
Need a special key for that room. Okay.
Okay, so we didn't see the key in the room that we started in. So he thinks we should go to the men's locker room to find this key. Speeding along. We gotta get more plot. Cat. Okay, so the men's locker room is actually around the corner. I really hope somebody looped this in 10 hours. Oh yeah, by the way, we can look up and see locker room man. Because that's how you sign you signage things. Locker room man. I keep things safe, but only if you put a lock on me. There he is again. Professor Crouch to the rescue! Right, Alessa? Everybody knew Robert. He was such a good man. He still has a choice. He can tell her to fuck off. It'd be stupid, but you still have a choice. I hate when people say that. I don't have a choice. The fuck you don't? Yeah, you do. Alright, so where the hell is... We have no indication of where his locker is. Wait, Robert's locker is the left one at the end. The vaguest clue in the world. Okay, so left at the end. No, nope. That's not it either. Alrighty. So this one? There we go. It's by the locker. The reference room key. And the very important file! Ring reference room. I can't find the 8mm film. It's an important file! Very important file. I wonder if this is the key to the reference room. Duh. This game really makes it kind of a point that you should just fucking forget about dead people. Don't feel anything about them. Just fucking... They're dead. Deal with it. Move on, pussy. That seems to be the theme of this game. And then it's like, well, at the same time, you should probably find out what killed them. But don't feel anything about it. Just do it. Fucker. Now we have the reference room key. Alessa doesn't like to be pet along to the rhythm of this music. I think it's a gripping soundtrack. Filled with layers of emotion. It's very technical. You get the guy hitting the same two notes on the piano. Da, 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 da. It's beautiful. it? This is it. It has a brilliant sense of impending doom and okay, so nothing there. Study on clairvoyance. That's the only book there. It's just a study on clairvoyance. Only some of them actually have flavor text, too. The curse. Why is a book like this here? This is a good question. This is the CD goddamn C. No, it shouldn't have any of this shit. What else is around here? What are these? They vent? I don't know. We're never going to find out because the game doesn't have any flavor text for that. Here we go. We found another very important file! Report concerning Ring. This is a report about the phenomenon... Oh my god. The phenomenon. Hello, chicken. Oh, no. It's done twice! That's beautiful. That occurred in Japan last October. This phenomenon occurred between September and October of 1990 and was over before year's end. The cause was determined as Sadako Yamamura's curse. Sadako copied her image to video using her powers, and anyone who saw the video died of a heart attack within 1 week of viewing due to Sadako's power curse. Ugh, that was painful to say. First of all, it's a run-on sentence. Second of all, Jesus God. How many times do you have to say it was a curse? It was a curse. You didn't have to call it a power due to her curse. Details unknown. No, you have the fucking details. Literally, you just explained everything that happened. There are no details unknown. We were unable to confirm the victim's corpses. How? How were you unable to? You have records. Note that the cursed video created by Sadako changed into a virus. Fuck you, that's how. It literally just writes it off. Like, this is the most half-assed way you could explain the plot of your fucking game. Is, you know, there's a movie about a curse that was a videotape. Now it's a fucking video game virus. Fuck you. That's how it works. That is just, like, the laziest goddamn synopsis I've ever seen. I've seen better user synopses on IMDb. Oh my god. How the virus came about has many hypotheses, including rewriting of DNA through the retina, or the creation within the... What the fuck does that mean? What? I get the rewriting of DNA, but that's not how DNA works, or how eyes work for that matter. And what the fuck do you mean by creation within the host? What creation? For this, we have gained access to the corpse of Sadako, so it is better to research that. Research what? Her body? Research in Japan found an autopsy where Sadako was alive for 30 years after falling in a well. It is best to determine this on your end. Attached is data concerning her birth. Now, if I remember correctly, in the movie, she dies in the well fairly young. Because she doesn't get fed, it's cold in the well, and, you know, she dies. I could have sworn she died at the age of 8. I'll have to look that up. But I'm pretty sure that this is wrong. Now, this one's beautiful. I don't know if it's jumping out at you yet, but give it a moment. Just give it a moment. and see if there's anything on this particular screen that strikes you as weird and completely unnecessary to literally anything. If you're playing along at home, you are correct. Female testicular syndrome. What the fuck? First of all, I've never heard of that. I'm not going to discount it because I don't know if that's a thing. And if it is, okay, I'll have to look it up. But what the fuck does that have to do with this game? What does it have to do with the character? It doesn't add anything. It seems just like they want to say female testicular syndrome. Just for the sake of fucking saying it. Holy crap. So Robert was investigating Ring. We know that. We've established that. But let's keep bringing it up. And then our favorite teleporting guard is back. Okay, sweet. Obviously, we've broken a rule. I came in here just because it was open. That's a terrible excuse. You don't have to be so mad at me. That's his fucking job. See, this is what he's supposed to be doing, is guarding places that you're not supposed to be. Granted, she's not supposed to be in the men's room either, but that's not where guards are supposed to be posted. Exactly. That, you know, it's off limits. Jesus. And again, thank you for, you know, echoing my thoughts. I'm gonna get out! Alright, yeah, go do that. Get out! In any case, get out! Ah! Ah! Everybody keeps coming and going. Busta said, I had to step out for a bit. Why the fuck is a guard... Why is the guard guarding here? Wasn't he in the bathroom? He's basically been in every single room. He was in the bathroom, he was in the men's locker room, and then he was also in here in the, Or no, he actually came into the research room after we came in. Alright, so Burger Gamer did the research for me because I was probably going to forget. And apparently, female testicular syndrome is when males are insensitive to androgens. Don't know what that is. So they're born as females despite having XY sex chromosomes. That wasn't a plot point in the movie. This literally does nothing to the character. It's just like some extraneous thing they decided to throw into the game because we gotta make up some lore. This arrogant pest, she's not even going to apologize. Who talks like this? Oh, man. Alright, so I'm gonna take a very short, very quick break. I have to check on my dinner and move my fish over back into his, fish bowl, so that should only take about 5 minutes, so enjoy this music while you wait. Thank you.
thanks for your patience. Hopefully that wasn't too long. So before, about a couple minutes ago, we literally established that Robert was investigating Ray, and now she's asking again, was he investigating this? I'm not quite sure. Her memory is worse than mine. Preposterous. So you can spell preposterous, but not phenomena. Okay. So now that we've done all of that, it's time to play the game again. Right, Mush? What? She's like, I'm out of kibbles. Oh, this game is The Ring, Terror's Realm for the Dreamcast. And this is amazing. I'm actually going to end up having to replay this because I'm going to do a long play of it. This is about as far as I got with this section of the game. I got to the point where I had to find another laptop. Dreamcast does have some great games, in my opinion. It just so happens that this is a terrible game. I have a couple of terrible games. I actually was streaming Kiss Psycho Circus, which is brutally painful and awful and sucky. Less a kiss. She attacks the microphone. Hi, sweetie. I can't believe that this game let me into the same spot that I was in before. How crazy! Alright, so for those of you who've just joined us, and, you know, just a recap for those who are watching and got bored. So this game is The Ring, Terror's Realm. Its pretense is that Sadako from the movie Ring U basically turned her curse, which originally was a videotape. And when you watch the videotape, you had 7 days to pass it to somebody else or you'd die. Now, her curse is in a video game. Because fuck you. And you have 7 days until you die. Because fuck you. And to not die, you have to, I don't know, because fuck you. I've literally not figured out what you're intended to do to not die to this. So this is how we get downstairs. Brainbuster says, it's Lawnmower Man 2. No, it's The Ring, because it's a curse, you see. I wonder if this is underground. No! Silly. Alright, so there's these weird servers standing here. Burger Gamer. Hey, Burger Gamer, you've been here a bit. I didn't get a chance to mention you. Sorry about that. Burger Gamer's here. Thank you for stopping by. Hope you're enjoying and having a good night. There, I just pew-pewed him. I don't even think I can. No, you can't manually reload weapons from this screen. You have to basically use up all of your ammo. You either use up all of your ammo, or you manually reload from this screen. Brilliant, brilliant gameplay. Okay, so another one is around. Ah, scary! Ah, I'm terrified. Woo! Aren't you all terrified too? Now, what I'm thinking we're gonna have to do for the LP is, like, I'm gonna be doing this obviously, so I'll just edit them out like I did the elevator scenes in Clock Tower 2, because I'll be standing in that spot, that same spot. I can literally just do the cut right before I go for the menu, and then cut back to it afterwards, and that should be fine. So we got a small battery, which is specifically for the flashlight. I'm leaving the flashlight on. We can't go that way for some reason. Checking bodies. Miss. There we go. Thankfully, it's stupid. Reload. There we go. So let's see what we got in this room. Got the ladder. And a doorway. So let's try this ladder. We gotta go over here. Can't go that way. Okay. That rules out a couple of paths. So let's check out these rooms. Room sealed. Spooky music. What's behind the door? Rhino says I'm watching a Stardew Valley playthrough later. Telephone's ringing. Cause, yeah. A silent prank call? What in the world is this? It's almost as if pranks are a thing that exist! This gives me a bad feeling, so does the game, to be quite honest. I thought it was indigestion, but no, it's just this game. I still love, this is my favorite thing ever. I'm like a little bunny, and going backwards, There's bathrooms here, and let me check the map real quick. Okay, because the reason I'm looking at the map is, in some small way, it reminds me of the laboratory, the CDC map, because of that placement of the bathroom. I'm gonna check that other map when we get to it again, but what I thought was that this is a other world version of our world, you know, bullshit Silent Hill stuff. that's being done terribly in this game. Right, Alessa? I'm getting cat looks. She doesn't have any kibble in her bowl. Because she ate it all. Scary! Even the bathrooms aren't safe. Jesus. Take every clip. Oh, okay. You know what? I'm kind of getting tired of wasting all my ammo. Let's try, I haven't used the knife yet. Let's try this. I'll use the laser sight. Damn. Holy shit, that's more effective, actually. Trying to get the... There we go. Handgun bullets. Excellent. And nothing. Good stuff. So this is actually pretty effective. Okay, so... I accidentally tried to turn the electricity on, but apparently there's no electricity. And I didn't know that because I was mashing the A button to try to open the door instead. Good game design. Let's check out the men's bathroom. We're being so naughty. Okay, what's in here? I hear, there he is. Beastie. Oop, that didn't work. That didn't know. Oh, that's new. Okay, so he can't be knifed, apparently. Better? Good? Better? Really? Those are the, that's... Whatever. Fuck it. I'm not questioning it. Yeah, so I guess he just moves too fast for us to knife. So let's try knifing this one and see if my theory is correct. And that he just moves faster. And while we're here, we'll just reload. Come on. Yeah, it is because of the slowness. So that thing just kind of has this weird reach. And then the other one's just super fast, so I can't... Unless I try to do a... Oh my god, really? Let me go in there! It's just kicking me out! There. See? How fucking hard was that? Shit game. Okay, so our flashlight's starting to get low on battery. Burger Gamer says, open the men's door in the security yard as they're glaring at you. See, that would have been scary. I actually would have been kind of terrified of that. Alright, so we've cleared this area. What's this door? Breeding room. Right. Go in the breeding room. I'd like to know how you save this game. We've been doing this for literally an hour and I haven't seen a save point. Oh, something's in here. Can't see it. Cause oh, hey, there we go. It is terrible at attacking. So let's grab our gun. It's moving way too fast. Back here. There we go. How are we on health now? Because we took a bit of a... Alright, so we're going to use some jelly. Oh, okay, so regular jelly only goes up by a tier, I guess. So we really don't need that. I'm guessing EX goes up by 2 tiers. Uh-oh. Something else is here. What? Didn't even grab it. Oh my god, just shoot the thing! Thank you! Holy shit! So, if I haven't mentioned it yet, this game is terrible. And frustrating. So there's another one of these guys. Don't surprise me. Thought you were him. So somebody's hiding around. I just want to get rid of him. Who else could it be? I don't fucking know. I'm glad we've settled into murdering shit. Okay, so we can't go in there. I'm not sure what these are. Are they supposed to be, like, lockers? Okay. So this room is... microscope. It's a room that's just basically a microscope. What's in here? Apparently this is an important room because it takes forever to load. Or, flashlight went out. What are you doing? We're fine here, so go check elsewhere. Are you guys seeing that okay? Or do I need to put up the brightness a bit? Because it looks kind of dark. How's that? It should be better. What is up with that? She said it out loud, but apparently he can't hear very well. Virus? The virus everybody's been talking about! We're counting on you to get the fuck out of here. So let's throw up our flashlight battery. Okay, so there's literally nothing else in this room. I could run around this room and I won't find anything. I'm gonna double check though, because I might be wrong, there might be an item. But last time I checked, yeah, there's nothing in here. That box doesn't actually do anything. A lot of the items in this game, the assets, are just there. As just kind of set dressing. They don't serve any purpose, there's no interactivity. I'm gonna check that room soon. What's this one? Opera? The fuck is an opera room? Operation? Opera? Is that where the opera happens? There's a lot that got lost in translation in this game. Come on. It's like a lizard monkey. Hey, Fearlex, thanks for stopping by. Hope you're having a great day. I appreciate you coming in. This is The Ring, Terror's Realm. Amazing, amazing, terrible game. So let's head over into this room, which was Microscope. And the S is capitalized for some reason. And he is hiding, huh? Yeah, this game is some kind of joke. Okay, so there's a computer. It doesn't do anything. Same with this one. Ah! What is this? By any chance, is this the one that sneaked in? There were like five fucking things we've killed! Yes, VLX, this literally is linked to the Ring movies. I love that. Oh my god. Can I actually, like, stab him? Instead of wasting ammo? Let's try stabbing. Just gonna jam on this A button here. Yes! Yes! Suck my knife! Beautiful. This screenshot right here sums up my feeling about this game. Even though this is a game, it doesn't feel all that great. It's nice if there's a laptop somewhere around here. The security office or one of the normal offices. How do I know what this place is? This is a small keyhole. We don't have a key. Oh, yes, we got a map. Good. So some enemies, if they're slow enough, we can spam them with the knife. So now into the opera room. Or not. So those are sealed. Alright, so this is where I ended last time. So I have to find my way to some offices. This is the Dreamcast. Wait a minute. So white is areas we haven't been in, and yellow are areas that we have. All right. So that makes sense. So, can I actually go in this other room now? Oh, wait, no, it was this one, wasn't it? No, we were in the breeding room. The breeding room. It's the cages. It gives off a bad feeling. Cages lined up. Let's see. Light switch. Let's turn. Flick it. No electricity. Okay. So where the fuck am I supposed to go? Because it's at this point we're an hour and a half into the game. We haven't hit any save points, which is a bit concerning. Okay, so this door we can go in. And the other one we can't. Let's try the stairs. You never know. So this is the stairs. Sealed off. Alright. So I guess we could try some of the ladders? Actually, I'm going to turn the flashlight off. I know it's going to be hard to see, and I'm actually having a hell of a time seeing right now. Fuck that. We're going to keep it on. I don't care if I run out of battery. Fuck that. Can't go there. Yep, we're going to hop on back. I'm here. Ah. Okay, so I can't hit him with the knife. Terrible. Doing awful. Starting to get to an idea of what I can hit and not. Can't go here for some reason. Can I go on this side of it? No. Oh my god, that is awful. Fuck. Ugh. Okay, what was the point? I guess we'll head back up to the first area? Nothing that way. Here. Nothing there. What's over here? Anything? No. Chemicals? Old and unusable. Too old, too old. What's all this? A control panel? So what do I do with it? Anything? Nothing? What's the point? No, Vrelax. I haven't actually finished Resident Evil. We will be finishing that. This is just so bad that I had to play it. Something like a monkey here earlier. Still no electricity, so we can't do anything with the light switches. There's really nothing up here, I think. No, this is just kind of the, it's just an area. It's of no consequence. So back down we go. I'm trying to think of where. Let's head back to the telephone room, maybe?
Also, how the fuck are you supposed to notice this? Like, I'm sorry, that was really... That took me forever to find the first time I played this. This manhole. It's just so badly placed. Alright. So... What? Oh, shit, that's weird. No? Is that a sloth? Alright, well, it's stuck. Holy shit! Wow! At least give me some items! What the fuck was that? Alright, where the fuck was this telephone? Okay, here it is. Nothing? Where should I call during the game? A dick. What's this? There's a laptop. Who is it? Oh, I feel eyes on me. Just me? So is that our escape? And where the fuck are the save points? I'm not doing this shit again. Yes! I am so glad we're back to this song. Phone call isn't coming this time. I know I am. Wait. So I can't call out. How the fuck do I save this game? Hold on, I have to find out. Because I don't want to go through this shit again. I need to know how the hell I'm supposed to save in this game. Save the game by using the camera. So there's a camera in this room? I'm not sure where. A radio. Oh, okay, so this is how we fucking save. That's not a camera, jackass. So that was to the person who wrote the FAQ that I tried reading. Oh yeah, and this also has the same sound effects as getting hit, by the way. Oh my god. That is amazing. I'm glad that there is something in this game that told me exactly how to do that, by the way.
Alright, so we're getting to the, going to the chief. What is up with that? It's nothing. It's nothing at all. Don't worry. Plus 500 internet to anybody who gets that reference. Just keep soaking it. This epic soundtrack. This room smells. It's you. You're the person that I called for. You know why you were called here? Moments ago, I told you to cool off your head. Well, I cooled off my head. Just on a whim. Just fucking say that you're following a lead. Like, that's... You're basically begging to be fired. Wasn't locked. Apparently we're really good at lying. So hold on, wait a minute here. So let me get this straight. We're working at the CDC. That's the Center for Disease Control. Alright, we've established that multiple times. The job of people who work at the CDC are to research, control, and hopefully eliminate diseases. I think I'm correct on that. So we are being forbidden to enter the research room, a room of a repository of information on diseases. What? Even if you're covering something up, don't you just take out the stuff that's part of the thing that you're covering up and leave everything else? You're literally making it impossible for another person in the company to do the job that they're supposed to do. The only job that they have. We're in a slight mess right now. No. This game is a steaming pile of mess. You should refrain from activities that will confuse those around you. Why would they go into a room? I do not understand. These women folk, they're so crazy. Women, am I right? I am right.
Right, Alessa?
Alessa's staring at me. Am I just tired? No, you're in a shitty game. I feel so dizzy. I can't stand still. I'm getting really dizzy. I need to go back to my room and rest. I can't. And plop. This was never a thing in any of the Ring movies either. Nobody got tired. They just died. Like, they went about their lives normally. This is literally getting all of the lore wrong. Hey now, snap out of the dream. This is a PG show. Right? Yeah. This is a dark-ass medical room. Ring U is a fantastic movie. The sequels are stupid. And the Ring remake is actually really good, too. Why are the lights off? There we are. Drawer opens, but there's nothing there, so glad that's the thing. Here, can we use the phone around the desk? Nope, we can't use the phone. Oh my god, that camera shake is doing my head in. Stop, woman, go. There, yes, no, yes. Okay, no, can't go there. It's over here, we can't go there. I also really liked Ju-on, the original Grudge movie. That was fantastic. Okay, so what do we do now? We could go check some of the other labs and see what's in them. Is the music too loud? Can you guys not hear me? Just a heads up, if it's too loud, please let me know. Is it better? It's Ju-on. J-U-O-N. So we need a card key for that one, and we need a key. Lab 4th. I guess we just head back to the room. Lights are off. Someone in here? Who's there? What are we about to uncover? I love how upbeat the music is while this shit's happening. Beautiful. And somehow he loses his key card. Brilliant. Okay, we get it. We've established the hell out of that key card. Thank you. Lab member level 2. Excellent. All right. Definitely saving it. Fucking beautiful sound effects. Fucking beautiful sound effects. Alright, well, I think that's where we're gonna call it for the night. Thank you guys for stopping by. I hope you all enjoyed this. And we will be back again with more The Ring Terror's Realm. This is phenomenal. Alright, have a good night, guys.